Hey all, and welcome to another one, and welcome to the next part of our Villa Intercom series. And today I'm going to show you how to add your doorbell onto your DVR or NVR. Okay, so essentially it'll be adding just like adding an IP camera. So the door station, the doorbell, you'll be able to see the video on the NVR or DVR, be able to get the playback, be able to hear the audio, you know, just like a normal camera, it will be recording, okay? So it will be stored, you know, continuously on your NVR, okay, or DVR. So what we're going to do, I'm going to show you two methods, guys. One is we're going to be using IVMS, so you should be familiar with IVMS now. And then I'm just going to show you guys how to do it, you know, through the monitor, just the GUI on the NVR DVR itself, okay? So if you're an end user and you want to do this, that is a lot easier method. But because we're using IVMS, let's go ahead and do it through IVMS. Let me show you guys how. So we've got our DVR added and we have our backdoor doorbell added. Okay, so we've actually mounted this doorbell. It's the one we use here for deliveries. And to add a camera, we go to camera management. But first of all, I'm going to show you guys, you know, just quickly what's going on. As you see here, it's our hallway camera. We have 8 cameras added and 3 IP cameras. Okay, we're going to add a 4th one. All right, guys, and then we'll be able to see the doorbell. So we go to system, camera management. We've got analog cameras. Now, if you've maxed out your IP cameras already and you have some analog cameras free, you can just unequip them here and then you can add more IP cameras. All right, but we've got one space free. So we're gonna go ahead and add our IP camera. So it's pretty straightforward, guys. Really, all you need is the password and the IP address, okay? So the IP address of our station is 10.4.4.70. Password is our standard password. There we go, okay. Okay, as you see, status is online, perfect. That means the password is correct and it's found the camera, no problem. So now we go back to image and we should have our IP camera here for our back door. Yeah, so this is our door station, guys, our backdoor doorbell, okay? So that's one method to add a doorbell, and I'm gonna quickly show you how to do it now through the screen. Catch you in a sec, guys. Hey guys, and welcome to the next part of this video, and a couple of things to let you know before I go ahead and show you how to delete and add a camera is that if you are using a DVR, a DVR can handle up to 4 IP cameras. So technically an 8-channel DVR is actually a 12-channel recorder. So it is very easy to add IP cameras onto a DVR. Obviously, to an NVR, IP camera is just a camera. So that's pretty straightforward, okay? The second point is, if you are just a home user and you want to add your doorbell to your recorder and you don't have an installer there, then this is the video for you guys to watch, okay? So you're going to need your IP address and the recorder, the camera password, okay? So if you've got those two bits of information, you're great, you're good to go. I can't help you with the password, but I can help you with the IP address. Just download a bit of software called SADP tool and you'll be able to find all the IP addresses on your network, okay? So let's go ahead and delete this camera and then re-add it again. So to do this on the DVR, we go to camera. And then as you see here, we have our 8 analog cameras and we've got max camera number, IP camera number here, 4. Perfect. So we go to IP camera. Now we have to delete this one. As you see, it's easy delete. Delete. Done. Now we go ahead and add again. So we go custom add. Now you put in the IP address. Now, even though if it looks for devices up here at the top, guys, it won't necessarily put the doorbells in there. Okay, so do be careful about that. But I know the IP address is 70, so let's go ahead and put that in here. And I also know our password is the same as our DVR. Okay, so I can use the channel default password. Now, if you've got a separate password, just pop it in there. Go to add. Connecting, and there we have added our doorbell again, guys. All right, so hopefully if you're an installer, you should set your customers up like this, and if you're an end user and you haven't got this, then hopefully now you should be able to do it. So thanks for watching another video, and almost wrapping up the series now, but more to come after this one, so don't worry, guys, working on some good stuff right now. So hopefully catch you in another one, and thanks, bye bye.